Okay, today's topic is a force on a current carrying conductor in a magnetic field. So what we have discussed in the previous classes and all, the formation of different types of magnetic field when a current is passed through a conductor. And first we discussed for a straight conductor along with the experiment of Easter. Then we have seen the pattern of field lines in a single loop of wire, then a solenoid, and how to convert solenoid into electromagnet and all. So here in force on a current carrying conductor in a magnetic field, in this activity we are going to learn about the working principle of electric motor. Can you tell me any device in your home which uses electric motor?
Fan.
Yeah, fan. Then?
Washing machine.
Then?
ACs.
AC also inside the AC for the working of the compressor, and for the fan inside the AC it need motor. Then?
Computer.
In computer, motor is there. Motor is there for two purposes. One is for, there is a cooling fan. For that fan there is a motor, and also one more motor is required when we are ejecting the CD. Movement of that CD tray, it need a motor. Any other?
Sir, in India people use motor for jetting the water. Yes.
Water from the sump tank in the ground level, water is lifted to the roof of the building by using an electric motor fitted with a centrifugal pump. A centrifugal pump is for lifting up water, and for rotating the pump we need an electric motor also.
Car.
In cars, toy cars you are saying?
Real car
is not electric motor. Electric cars are there, and also for cleaning purpose, shopping malls and all, some vehicles they are using. Okay, that is electric. But normal cars are not electric, they are working with a diesel or petrol, that is heat engine, not electric. In your
grinders.
kitchen many items are there.
Grinders.
Yeah, grinder, mixer. In short, we can say like this: if there is any instrument, any device which is having moving parts, moving, rotating, or any moving parts, by using electricity there will be electric motor. Got it?
Microwave oven
inside that, for the movement of the tray there is an electric motor. Inside the refrigerator also, fridge also, refrigerator, there are many fans working, compressor working. So in short, you can remember like this: in any device in which if there is any moving part, rotation or motion, by using electric current, that will be done with the help of an electric motor. You might have seen drilling machine, cutting machine for cutting marbles, tiles and all. So can you imagine a day without electric motor?
No.
Your mother will say goodbye from the kitchen, isn't it?
Yes.
If mixer is not working, grinder is not working, washing machine is not working, that we are going to learn about that. What is the working principle of electric motor? So in this topic, force acting on a current carrying conductor in a magnetic field, it is the working principle of electric motor. Now you can see in the activity here, first of all we need a U-shaped magnet. Can you see the screen?
Yes.
Okay. So there is a U-shaped magnet here with the north pole at the bottom and south pole at the top. Okay. And in between the gaps of the U-shaped magnet, an aluminium rod is hanging. This is an aluminium rod. And this aluminium rod is suspended with the help of conducting wires. Very thin, soft conducting wires are used for hanging, suspending. And this wires used for hanging the aluminium rod, it is also used for passing electricity through that. So it is connected to a cell, means the wires used for, the two wires are used for suspending or hanging in between the U-shaped magnet, and also for passing electric current from the cell. And there is a switch here. Okay. And another point, the rod here, this conducting rod here hanging, it is aluminium rod. Why I am saying aluminium rod? Can we use iron rod here?
No.
Why iron rod is not used?
Because it will attract.
Yeah, iron rod will be attracted by the magnet. Without passing current itself, iron rod will be attracted.
Yes.
Now, see, the observation is this one. Suppose we are switching on the circuit and the current is passing. You can see here right now, the cell, the upper part is the positive, bottom is the negative. So if the connection is given like this, you can see how the current will be flowing. The current is coming through this switch, okay, this way, and it is passing through the aluminium rod this direction. This is the direction of current right now. Right now the current is flowing in this direction. This is the direction of current flow through the rod. And because of that current flow, the aluminium rod will experience a force in the magnetic field. Because as the current flows through the aluminium rod, you know that surrounding the aluminium rod, a magnetic field will be created. And that magnetic field will have a force of attraction or repulsion depending on the magnetic field of the U-shaped magnet. As a result, the aluminium rod may be thrown out of the magnet, U-shaped magnet, this direction, or it may be thrown this direction, any one direction, depending upon the direction of this current. So the hanging, yes, the hanging aluminium rod, when a current passes through it, it will experience a force, and because of that force it will be deflected, it will be thrown either out of the magnet or into the magnet. In which direction, in which direction the aluminium rod will be thrown out, it is given by Fleming's left hand rule. You can see here, this is Fleming's left hand rule. Already we have one right hand rule, isn't it? Right hand thumb rule. Now it is Fleming's left hand rule. Again, Fleming's right hand rule also is there. Now listen here. According to Fleming's left hand rule, you can see the three fingers of your left hand. Okay? See the three fingers of left hand, the thumb, the index finger, and the middle finger. These three fingers are kept in mutually perpendicular direction, perpendicular to each other. If you take the angle between the thumb and the middle finger will be 90 degree, the index finger and middle finger will be 90 degree, index finger and middle finger will be 90 degree, index finger and thumb will be 90 degree, means mutually perpendicular to each other like this. Okay, then you can remember, see in physics the symbol used for magnetic field is B. Can you see in the figure?
Yes, sir.
The symbol used for B in capital B means magnetic field in physics. Capital E means electric field. Okay. So, you can easily remember this one. FBI. What is FBI? It's not the investigation agency. Federal Bureau of Investigation of US. You know that? FBI. Like our, yes, CBI. Like our CBI. This is FBI. It is not Federal Bureau of Investigation. F is the force acting on the aluminium rod. B is the direction of magnetic field and I is the direction of current. Got the point? So according to Fleming's left hand rule, you have to stretch the three fingers of your left hand, not the right hand. Right hand will be a different one. Okay, there is right hand also coming. You have to stretch the three fingers, the thumb, index finger and middle finger of your left hand, mutually perpendicular to each other. Then if the index finger represents the direction of magnetic field, the middle finger represents the direction of current, and the thumb will point in the direction of force acting, in the direction of force acting on the conductor. Okay, can you apply that in the figure in the screen? Can you try and tell me which direction the aluminium rod will be thrown? If you apply this rule in the figure given on the screen, what will be the direction of deflection of aluminium rod? You can see in the figure, the activity here, north pole is down, south pole is up, so magnetic field will be upward direction. Okay, in the figure, direction of magnetic field is this way. This is the direction of magnetic field, means we can say it is B. B is this one. Then current in the rod is flowing this direction. This is the direction of current. Then what will be the direction of force acting? What is the direction of force acting? Right now in the figure, as I have drawn here, when we switch on the, here there is a switch here. When we switch on the circuit, current is coming from the positive of the cell, this way, through the wires, and it is passing through the aluminium rod this direction. This is the aluminium rod. So current is in this red color arrow. And magnetic field is always from north to south. North is at the bottom, south is at the top. So magnetic field is upward direction. Then if you apply on your left hand, these two direction, index finger, the direction of magnetic field, and middle finger in the direction of current, what is the direction of force acting on the aluminium rod? You have to tell the answer, into the magnet or out of the magnet, into the U-shaped magnet or out of the U-shaped magnet. It is out of the magnet, this middle finger upward. Okay, this finger in the direction of red arrow means that the direction of current. Then this finger is, if you show on the screen, not in the video, video will be opposite because it is having mirror effect. first we have to apply forefinger or index finger, that is the direction of magnetic field, that is from the bottom to up. Then apply current direction, that is into the screen, correct?
Yes.
Into the screen. And index finger is upward. Then what is the direction of your thumb? Into the magnet or out of the magnet?
Out of the magnet.
Very good. That is answer. Force will be acting out of the magnet. You are seeing the video?
Yes.
Don't see the video. See the picture on the screen only. Okay. Video will have opposite effect. All of you remember, in according to the Fleming's left hand rule, the three fingers, the thumb, index finger and middle finger, they are stretched perpendicular to each other, mutually perpendicular to each other. Then in the picture you can see on the screen, the magnetic field north pole is at the bottom and south pole is upward. So your index finger, first you have to point from bottom to up, upward direction. Then current, you can see the current direction is shown with the red arrow, that is into the screen, into the screen. It is three-dimensional diagram. So you have to show the middle finger into the screen. Then you see what is the direction of your thumb. Your thumb will be out of the magnet. It means the aluminium rod will experience a force out of the magnet. Got it?
Yes, sir.
Now if we are reversing the current, suppose current is reversed in the opposite direction, then you can see your thumb will be into the magnet. If the current direction is reversed, then you can see the aluminium rod will be deflected into the magnet. So depending upon the direction of current as well as magnetic field, force also will change.
Yes, sir.
So according to Fleming's left hand rule, see here, stretch the three fingers, your thumb, your index finger and the middle finger in mutually perpendicular direction. That time, if the thumb is pointing towards magnetic field B, B stands for magnetic field, and the middle finger points in the direction of current, okay, current I, then the thumb will give the direction of force acting or deflection of the aluminium rod or the conductor placed in the magnetic field or the current carrying conductor placed in the magnetic field. So you can easily remember this one, FBI. F is the force, B is the magnetic field direction and I is the current direction. Okay, FBI. Thumb will point in the direction of force acting and the index finger in the direction of magnetic field B and middle finger in the direction of current I. Next point. Now what will be the magnitude of force? How much force will be experienced? Now we got the direction of force only. How much force will be experienced on the aluminium rod? You can easily remember that by using an equation, but this equation is not in your lesson. But right now I am giving the equation so that you can easily remember this one. Suppose you are going for a dinner in a hotel. After having the dinner,
Bill,
you will not forget, I think. So you can remember bill here, B-I-L. It is not hotel bill. It is bill for the force acting. So F is equal to bill. Here not only bill, along with the bill, you have to add one sine theta also. Just remember sine theta. Sine theta means it is the ratio between the, if you take a right angle to triangle, if I take this angle as theta, then sine theta is the ratio between opposite side by hypotenuse. If you take any triangle, take this side, length of this side and length of this hypotenuse and find the ratio opposite by hypotenuse, that ratio is called what?
Sine theta.
Sine theta is equal to opposite side by hypotenuse. Suppose I am naming this triangle as ABC. If I am naming the triangle as ABC, then what I can write? Sine theta is equal to AB by BC. Now here what can be B? What will be B here? B representing
the magnetic field.
Yeah, magnetic field. And I?
Current.
And L? L is the length of the aluminium rod. Okay. L is the length of the aluminium rod. So the force acting on this aluminium rod, it depends upon magnetic field, means the strength of magnetic field. If you use a strong magnet, force will be more. It depends on current, directly proportional to current also. If you pass more current, instead of one cell, if you connect two cells, there will be more force acting on the aluminium rod. And it depends on the length also. If you use a long aluminium rod, force also will be more. It depends on the length of the aluminium rod. And also it depends on the theta. Theta means it is the angle between, right now here theta is, this is the angle theta, it is the angle between the direction of magnetic field and the direction of current, this angle. What is the angle right now between the direction of magnetic field, magnetic field is upward, current is flowing this way. What is the angle between the direction of current and magnetic field?
90 degrees.
Yeah, the angle here it is 90 degree. Angle between the direction of current and magnetic field is 90 degree. And here in this equation, when we apply the value, BIL, sine 90 will come. See, sine theta value is maximum. The maximum value of sine theta is 1. 1 is the maximum. Maximum value of sine theta is 1. That will come when theta 90 degree. Sine 90 equal to 1. Sine 90 is 1. So force will be maximum BIL. BIL is the maximum force. When theta equal to 90 degree, sine 90 equal to 1. Sine 90 become 1. Remaining force will be BIL. It means if the aluminium rod is hanging perpendicular to the direction of magnetic field. If the aluminium rod is hanging like this, perpendicular to the direction of magnetic field, then theta is 90 degree, force acting will be maximum. Now if you imagine these fingers as the U-shaped magnet and this pen as the aluminium rod, the pen is hanging between like this. Now if you see, suppose my thumb is north pole and the upper one, the index finger is south pole. Magnetic field is from north to south, upward direction, and the current is flowing through the pen in this direction and it is hanging like this. Now what is the angle between the direction of current and the direction of magnetic field?
90 degrees.
So force will be maximum. Now if I am hanging the conductor like this, force will decrease. Like this, force will decrease. Got it? If the conductor is hanged like this, in the same direction, downward or upward, like this. The U-shaped magnet is here and the conductor is hanging either this upward direction or downward direction. Suppose the aluminium rod is hanging in this direction, vertically upward. Magnetic field is upward, current through this aluminium rod also upward. Then what will be theta equal to?
Zero.
If theta is equal to zero, sine zero is equal to zero. Then what will be force acting? Force will be BIL into zero. BIL into zero means zero. In what alignment, in what orientation of the aluminium rod, force will be maximum? Theta equal to?
90 degree.
When it is hanging 90 degree means it is perpendicular to the direction of magnetic field. If the aluminium rod is hanging like this, perpendicular to the direction of magnetic field is from north to south this way, and if it is hanging like this, then angle between the direction of current through this aluminium rod and this magnetic field will be 90 degree, that time force will be maximum. If it is hanging this way or this way, force will decrease, and this direction if it is hanging, force will be zero. Sine zero equal to zero, so force will be zero. Got it?
Yes.
So the force acting on the aluminium rod is given by BIL sine theta. BIL, in BIL sine theta, B is the strength of magnetic field, I is the strength of current, L is the length of the conductor. And sine theta, theta is the angle between direction of current and direction of magnetic field. And theta value, if it is 90 degree, sine 90 equal to 1 is the maximum value. So force will be maximum when theta is 90 degree. Force magnitude is given by BIL sine theta and direction is given by Fleming's left hand rule. Okay. Now I will show you the experiment of this one.
Okay. This is the experiment. You can see here. U-shaped magnet, it is placed in a horizontal way. This red is the north pole and blue is the south pole. So the magnetic field is coming out of the screen. So your index finger should be towards you, out of the screen, perpendicular to the screen. And this AB is the aluminium rod. And here there is a cell and a rheostat and a switch. And you can see the cell is connected like this. The positivity of the cell is here and current is flowing from positivity of the cell through the rheostat, through the key, and current is flowing upward direction, and the magnetic field is from north to south. So what will happen when the magnetic field is north to south and the current is flowing upward direction, when we switch on the circuit, we can see according to the Fleming's left hand rule, the aluminium rod will deflect into the magnet. Okay, see it. See, it is deflecting into the magnet. Now the cell is reversed. See, the deflection is reversed. Once again, see, when the current is flowing the upward direction, the aluminium rod is deflected into the magnet. Now we are reversing the cell. Now it is moving opposite direction. Depends on the direction of current, direction of deflection also will change. Okay? Thank you.
The magnet. And this is the working principle of electric motor. Based on this force acting on a current carrying conductor in a magnetic field, an electric motor works. And more details about this we'll discuss in next class. Okay? Okay, thank you.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.